Hey, how's it going? It's Elge from Simple Lines Anatomy. In this video, we got to talk about some mask usage today, more specifically about how to breathe effectively as we can when we're wearing a mask. And this is a bit of a sensitive subject right now for some people, and that's understandable. Just to understand, this is not so much about what's right or wrong. We're talking about breathing well while wearing a mask. There's some of this in the healthcare field right now that we have to wear a mask to work. And we're just going to make the best of that situation. That's the real goal here. Anyways, so you'll notice I got a couple of views going on here. We've got more of a front view of a mask, and we've got like a side view of a mask. We're illustrating this in the form of a surgical procedural mask, which we often wear, but the same general rules apply for any type of mask, whether it's even just a bandana or like your N95. There's slight exceptions, of course, and there's all kinds of fancy vents you can get now, but this should make sense. And this is the more commonly worn one anyways. So here's the thing. When you're wearing a mask, you'll notice that there's this essentially pocket. We're looking at it from the side, understand. The sides of this are relatively open, but we've got like a pocket here where air can be exchanged into. And let's assume, for just this example, that we've not got much airflow out of anywhere from these masks. It's not enough, let's say. That's not the case in a real mask, but let's just pretend for a second. So we've got air being exhaled like that. And you'll notice it gets kind of caught up in this pocket, especially if we don't have any way of getting it out. And when that's the case, what we start to get is the buildup of CO2 in the air. That's carbon dioxide, one part carbon, two parts oxygen. And if we have more CO2 in this area of breathing in this smaller pocket here, that means as we breathe in, as we breathe that air back in, we get more CO2 entering our lungs and therefore more CO2 in our bloodstream. This is normal in a way. You do have to understand that CO2 in the air is totally fine because when O2, oxygen, goes in, it comes back as CO2. It gets exchanged by cellular respiration, for instance, and it comes back as CO2. So there's always a certain amount of CO2 in the blood, and there's always a certain amount of CO2 proportionally in your air, and nitrogen too. That's not relevant today, but and nitrogen too. So the body is perfectly fine having this. And in fact, you'll notice that at higher levels of physical training, high levels of physical exertion, the CO2 level goes up to a certain point, totally fine. The blood gets more acidic because of it. But this can be sustained for long periods of time without it really being an issue. It's not going to kill you immediately. It's not going to be a problem immediately. It'd have to be very high for a long period of time to really be a problem. Conversely, in fact, it's a problem to have very low CO2 in the blood. The blood gets too basic, and that messes with some of the chemical processes in the blood, and that can be very dangerous too. So it's about proportions, really. So I'm just going to get rid of that. Now, let's say, for instance, we actually take away that amount of restriction. We get rid of the mask entirely, so no mask. So what's happening when we take away the mask? And this is just normal respiration. As we get more air out, we're capable of breathing well, and that's all good. And what will happen is there'll be a certain amount of CO2 in that air. There's again our CO2 in orange, but there's actually a small amount of O2 within that. It's not a perfect system. It's kind of a myth to think the body is 100% perfect with its oxygen and CO2 exchange. And so do understand that when you're breathing out in the mask, there is a bit of O2 in there. So it's sustainable for a period of time. But what happens because of the way gases naturally exert forces, the balance happens. So if there's plus O2 here and there's more CO2 here, there's more CO2 as we breathe out. These will exchange well. It's just natural this happens. It's not really a big deal. The body takes advantage of that, both inside and outside. So if this is the lungs here, and we've got a higher proportion of CO2 in the blood, so there's plus CO2 here, it will also work this way. The CO2 will move out and then be exhaled out just based on this exact same natural law. It's in fact very convenient. We're totally dependent on this, and it's great that this happens. So these will balance out. So the oxygen that we've lost or converted into CO2 will be returned because we've got lots of space for it around here. We got no restraining mechanism, no blocking mechanism for that to happen. And so we can effectively breathe O2 in, we can breathe CO2 out in the right amounts, which is great. So we want that. Perfect. We're very happy about that. Now, here's the thing. When we have one of these proper masks on, our surgical procedural mask, what you'll notice is it's not that restricted. And in fact, the sides are open. This is not a great illustration. The sides are relatively open. And this allows for CO2 to be removed from the area. Again, there's our CO2. So through essentially vents on either side. They're just open spots. Oftentimes you'll find it goes up this way. Totally fogs up your glasses. That's a good reason to breathe through your nose. There's another more important one to do that for, which I'll mention later, but definitely we've got some vent ports. So what you'll notice is that we've got a higher proportion of CO2, and we're on the lower end of the O2. The O2 is not so much minus O2 here. And so what we need is the local area gases to reestablish the balance, and it's just a little bit slowed. That's the thing about the mask. It's not that the CO2 is held there, not really, because it can't be for that long. If it's open on the sides, if it's worn properly and made properly, it will be able to diffuse back to a fine proportion. It will be totally fine. You'll get enough oxygen and you'll clear enough CO2. The thing is, you have to breathe slower than you normally would. Breathe too fast and it gets to be a problem. So going back to our side view here, essentially if we throw that mask back on and we get a blocking of that CO2 and we breathe really, really fast for whatever reason, pardon me, we breathe really, really fast here, too much, then it just circulates within that and you can raise your CO2 level very quick. Whereas if instead we breathe at a speed that is normal, like so, we breathe at a slower speed, you'll find that in fact you give more than enough time for the oxygen and CO2 to diffuse back to normal proportions and your breathing is fine. So the problem with all this is when we breathe too fast and through our mouth. Just to explain, this is a simplified model of how this works, but it is more or less how it works. There's a lot more neurologic responses that can be involved in this, but that's way too complicated for this explanation. In any case, we've got CO2. So let's assume that we're breathing a little too fast or we're excited or something, and the CO2 goes up. So we've got positive CO2, more than we normally would have in that mask. When that happens, if we do this the wrong way, if we do this in a less effective way, the CO2 being higher will cause the respiratory rate, our rate of breathing, to go up. This is normal, and this is a good thing that this happens in a normal situation, because if you breathe faster, you should clear more CO2. You should. But if we got something restricting that, that can be a problem. Again, if we had a full bag over our mouth or something, or we had no breathing capacity, yeah, again, very big problem. But this, again, not the case. We've got a properly made mask. We've got air exchange. And so if we start to retain that CO2 in our bloodstream and in our lungs, we increase that respiratory rate. With an increased respiratory rate, there's kind of a couple of things that can happen. So we start to activate our sympathetic system if it's been long enough. This is not instantaneous. This is just often what happens. And it makes it so that certain blood flow changes happen in the body. More specifically, there's lots of them, but you know, more specifically, we can say that the heart rate increases, the respiratory rate again will increase, and we get bronchodilation, and we get positive, more blood flow to our musculoskeletal system, really the muscles themselves. And this is a higher energy consuming thing. So unfortunately what this results in is more CO2 production, because it is a stimulatory system. Once we activate our sympathetics, what we know as the fight or flight system, we tend to get more CO2 produced as a byproduct, and we tend to get more blood flow into the system that would make us want to run away. And this is why sometimes you can get an increase in anxiety as a problem, as a secondary result from wearing one of these masks. But here's the thing, if you can instead breathe at a slower rate, you will find that you give more than enough time for the air and CO2 to properly exchange and the O2 to move back into the general area, and you can essentially stop that from happening. You can make it so that it doesn't happen. So this gets blocked off, which means the respiratory rate doesn't go up because you are actively in control of that. Sympathetics don't get stimulated, and none of that happens, and none of that happens. So this is good. We definitely want this to happen. Slowing down your breath, something under your voluntary control, can essentially break this cycle. It makes it very much possible to do. Get rid of these. Now, another thing we can also do is breathe through our nose. And so here's the thing about breathing through our mouth by comparison. Breathing through our mouth naturally stimulates our sympathetics. It makes it so that our sympathetics can get turned up easier. If you breathe through your mouth, it doesn't mean you automatically go into a fight or flight response. That's not true. But the body associates that breathing through the mouth with an increased sympathetic state, because we're pumping our lungs just that much more and faster too. We've got a bigger mouth hole versus our nose holes, and so it means that I can get more oxygen in and more CO2 out rapid. I'm stretching out those respiratory muscles faster and I'm activating them harder. And so the body tends to default to a naturally sympathetic state, which again increases the heart-lung stuff, which will eventually lead to CO2, which even worsens this response, should you allow it. So, the two real simple things, the two main things, the only things you actually need to know about this, I'm happy if you learn some things about breathing mechanics and CO2 and oxygen exchange, but the two main things is that we breathe through our nose, again, to reduce our natural sympathetic stimulation, and so you don't fog up your glasses, and that we breathe slower than you normally would. These are the two main things. And in fact, breathing slowly will also calm you down in general, aside from just getting that oxygen CO2 exchange to happen right. And this is a relatively simple thing you can do regularly throughout your day while you're wearing that mask on your 12-hour shift or however long it happens to be. Maybe you do eights. And it's a very simple thing to do. Now, we do have to say, if you have a previous medical history, if you've had lung problems in the past, this may not work out for you. You may need to consider alternatives like a face shield, one of those plastic clear face shields instead. These are a great alternative, but you really do have to discuss that with your doctor and your health professional, because that's a very different consideration. You'll notice that, you know, young 18 to 22 year olds who are in peak physical condition have no problems with us. But those of us in the healthcare field, maybe we have a few more miles on us. Maybe we have a few more stresses in life. Maybe we're not exactly young anymore. And so we need to train our bodies a little bit differently. We need to make an extra effort just to get things to happen well. And that's reality. That's age. That's fun. You know. And I guess last thing I will just say, practice and practice again all the time. To get used to this, you have to break the association of breathing faster, because your body will kind of want to do that naturally. So you need to practice with the mask off, maybe, to get used to just breathing and being aware of your breath. And then you need to take some time practicing in short periods with the mask on. And you need to associate the mask with a slow breath through your nose. If you're capable of doing that, everything should be fine. Good luck on your shift, and have a great day, I hope. And I hope that made sense.